This tutorial will show how the immuneML Galaxy web interface can be used for a repertoire classification task. The first step is to get our data into Galaxy. We can either upload it from files locally or retrieve it from an external database. And I will here upload 100 repertoire files, of which 50 have a disease and 50 do not. And in addition, I will upload one metadata file, which describes which of the repertoires have the disease and which do not. And once our data has been uploaded, it will show here on the right side of the screen in the Galaxy history. Now we can turn our uploaded files into an immuneML dataset using the Create Dataset tool. We select Repertoire Dataset because we want to predict the disease per repertoire. If we instead want to predict antigen binding, then we should select one of these other dataset types. Our data format is AIR, and the metadata file should be selected here. And then in this field, we have to select all of the repertoire files. But it is a bit inconvenient to have to click all these 100 files. So an alternative trick is to make a Galaxy collection out of the repertoire files and select it here. To do this, we have to go to the Galaxy history and click Operations on Multiple Datasets. Here we select all of the repertoires, so we have to exclude the metadata file. And then for all selected, build dataset list and give it a name. So I call it repertoires here. And then click create list. There will now be a new Galaxy history element that contains all of the repertoires. Also click operations on multiple datasets again to go back to the normal history view. And now we can go back to the data files field and toggle the menu to go to dataset collections. And here we can select our collection of repertoires. And finally, we click execute to start the tool. Once the dataset has been created, it will show up as a Galaxy history element named immuneML dataset. We can also view a summary of the created dataset, which can be useful to check if everything went as expected. So here we see that we have a repertoire dataset containing 100 repertoires and containing a label called signal disease, which may be used for classification. Training machine learning models for repertoire classification can be done through two different tools. The first offers a simplified interface, and the second is based on a YAML specification file. I will here show how to use both, starting with the simplified interface. So here we select our dataset. The label we would like to predict was called signal disease. And these next questions are used to determine how our data should be encoded. So in other words, how we want to represent our data to the machine learning model. Next, we select which machine learning methods we would like to use, and we can change some settings related to how the training is done. This tool uses nested cross-validation to train the machine learning models. And if you scroll down, you can also read a bit more background information that explains the different machine learning concepts and shows how this tool works internally. And finally, to run the tool, click execute. The simplified interface only provides a limited set of options. And to have full control over your immuneML analysis, you should use the Yaml-based tool for training machine learning models. This tool takes in a YAML specification, optional additional files, and a dataset. To get this YAML specification in Galaxy, we can upload a file like we did before, or we can click paste or fetch data and then copy paste in an example specification, for example, from the documentation. But also, the simplified interface outputs the YAML specification that was used to run immuneML, which can be found in this history item called repertoireclassification.yaml. So this is what it looks like. And if we now want to make some small changes to this YAML specification, the easiest way to do that is to click on the history item so it expands, then click visualize this data and go to the editor. So what I will do now is I will add a second encoding, which is not possible in the simplified interface. And I will give the second encoding k is 4. And then I also need to make sure that I add the second encoding down here to tell immuneML that we want to also test this in combination with both the two machine learning methods. And then we click export. And our new YAML specification will now show up as a new history item here. So this is what it looks like. So now we go back to the Galaxy tool. We select our new modified YAML specification and we select our dataset and click execute. The output for the simplified and YAML-based Galaxy tools is mostly the same. Both tools output a summary, archive, and optimal ML settings history element. The only difference is that the simplified tool also in addition outputs a repertoire classification YAML file. In the summary history item, we find an overview of the results. In this first table, we see for each of the five splits into training and test sets, what the optimal encoding and ML method were. And when we scroll down, we find a plot that shows the performance of each of the combinations of encoding and ML method across the five splits. We can click See Details to find more information about the model performance in a specific split in the outer cross-validation loop. And when we scroll down and click Selection Details, we see information about the performance in the inner cross-validation loop. We can also click See Reports, which shows additional information and plots related to the machine learning models. So here, for example, we see a plot of the coefficients of a logistic regression model. And when using the YAML-based Galaxy tool, you can also specify to see other types of reports. The next history item is a downloadable archive, which contains all of the raw results as exported by immuneML. And finally, optimalmlsettings.zip contains the optimal machine learning method and encoding that were trained for the label signal disease. And if you want to apply this trained model to a new dataset with unknown values for this label, then that can be done using the Apply Machine Learning Models to New Data tool. Now, if you want to try out immuneML for yourself, an easy way to get started is by following one of the Quickstart tutorials.